Hello guys, welcome to GIS Man, it's Miles Lee here. This is a channel about introducing the GIS technology and GIS knowledge that I used in my daily GIS works. The initiative to create this channel is, on one hand, I would like to remind myself of some details that I met in my work, which might be useful in future. And on the other hand, I would also like to share this experience to the audience all around the world, no matter you are in GIS industry or not, as long as you are interested in such things. And if such videos can help you one day in your work, I will be really happy and appreciate it. So let's get started. And by the way, as you can hear my very strong Cantonese accents, so if my presentation is not that clear, or you know, my speech is not that clear, no worries, just look at the screen, look at my code, I think you'll be okay. So let's get started now. Today's topic is about develop the customized hierarchy layers in ArcGIS Experience Builder. Yes, that's right, the ArcGIS Experience Builder instead of ArcGIS Webapp Builder. ArcGIS Experience Builder is a pretty new product, I think it's from 2019. It has the potential to replace the ArcGIS Webapp Builder in future, I think. But however, at this time, if you check the official website, the simple code, the documents are not that enough yet. And even you search such topics on YouTube, you can barely see there are mainly these types of videos. So this is also a reason I would like to make such videos to share my experience and investigations to all of you guys. So let's get started. So beforehand, I would like to show you what is expected to be seen at the end of the product. So actually it's like this. Today we are doing the hierarchy layers, two level hierarchy layers, which you can turn on the single layers like this. Or turn everything at one time like this. Yep. So it can be expanded, it can be collapsed. Yeah. And also when you click on each title of the layers, it will be linked to the ArcGIS Portal's page. Right? Okay. Actually, I also do other types of widgets. I'm continuously doing some other widgets as well, but I'm not going to talk about these. If you are interested in such things and how to do that, please make the comments below, and I'm very happy to make other videos later to describe how it's done. So yeah, let's get started. So actually, what you can see right here, I remove everything, and then because I would like to show you everything step by step from the scratch. So because as what you can see, this is a two level hierarchy layers, so we need to have a proper data structure to represent such data layers. So firstly, what we need to do is to define our data structures right here. We need two files. One is the basic functions from ArcGIS. We need to use these basic modules from ArcGIS, which is esri, layers, feature layers, yeah. And then we will need to export this function object. We just create a function, name whatever you want by URL. So here we will need to pass two parameters. One is the URL, another one is the layer ID, which we can use to identify which layer we are clicking. So here we will need to create a class object. So here URL is URL, ID, we will need to have that as well. And then we will defaultly set the visible to be true. We don't need to hide anything, right? So after that, just return the object. Okay, so after this, we will need to have the layers data structures. So we will need to import the previous defined objects. So now we export a constant source object. So you can go back to the page. We see, for example, the first layer is boundaries, and the second layer is urban, local government area, state, electoral district, something like that. So we will need to have the objects inside the array. And the array name will become the first level layer's name. And then the object, or each of the objects, will have their own names to represent the sub layers. So first one, we will have the boundaries and array. The name of the first sublayer will be server, and then the URL would be, I prepared this one, is the map layers. Is the map layers in the map server. You can also use the ArcGIS feature services. It's up to you. Yeah, but our organization, the backend people, they create the map layers like this. So I just like to use this. Yeah. And by the way, this is also the layer number, which you can define it right here with another attribute called layer ID. But I don't like this style because sometimes, I mean, it will be confused, you know. Yeah, so we will have a URL and then the layer ID. The layer ID here, I will need it to be incrementally, automatically. So we need to have an index, then to string. That's it, it's not defined. So I mean, hopefully, yeah, no prefix. Sometimes I just too realize on the prefix, which is not good. Okay, so this is the first sub layers. I define that. You will need to have a couple of more. So just copy these. And what's the second layers? Let's take a look. The second layers with the local government area. Okay, the local government area will be the second layers. Okay, yeah, so the first group is done. We don't like that much in the view product because this is just an example. So we like to define the second group, which is the ABS. The first one is, well, remember, is like yeah, it's a very long name. Just copy and paste. Okay. and then the URL is gonna to be these map layers. Oh, sorry, these map layers. Okay, again, the layer ID will be automatically increment. You don't need to worry, so that you don't need to worry too much. Then we need another one. What's the name of the second one? Let's take a look. Okay, is this. Let's copy and paste. And the second one, we are gonna be changed to layer one. Okay, this is our data structures. So we come back to our main menu. So here, what we need to do is to import that data structures right here, and then register each layer state in the state of the, because the state is necessary in React.js. So actually we will need to register each layer's status in the state to represent whether it's checked or not, whether it's collapsed or not. And then, yeah, this should be done before or after the render. You will need to also know a bit about the life cycle of the React.js, because in React.js, I mean, there are a couple of life cycles. If you don't know about the life cycles, I mean, just take a look at W3S tool. I mean, there are quite a lot of tutorials right here. So we will need to, so here, I mean, when I did this, I just register all the state of the layer status before, after the render, after the rendering. So we do it right here, the component did mount. Yep. So firstly, what we need to do is to import the source we just defined. We need to just import the sources we just defined in our previous module. Right? And then after that, we will need to give a global the global variables layers right here. And then after that, we can do some things in our component mount. When we register states, we will need to use the native JavaScript object. This is the mother's object of everything. These.layers.sources.map. We need to map each key. The key is the array name. The key right here. If we go back, it's array name, like ABS, like boundaries. We need to map all of this with the high-level function called map. Of course, you can also use, I mean, if it's in an array, you can also use for each or that kind of things, but I prefer here, I prefer to use the key stuff. Yeah, sorry, there is another arrow functions inside. Don't forget about this. Like to map everything key with index right here, and then set the state. Here there is a technique which is set the dynamic state. We use the middle size bracket to brand the key and set all the initial states as false, which means that at the beginning everything is unchecked, right? Everything is unchecked. So after that, we will need to set the second sublayers, the sublayers state. Need to map everything and also error functions right here. Need to map the layer. This is the sublayers. The first one is the array, the group's name. The second one will be the sublayer, right? So we write it here, the second, I mean, to avoid our own confusions. So this set state. Also use a dynamic setting, layer ID, right? And then set everything to be false at the beginning. Yep. So that's right. Yeah. So so currently, we have already done the data structures, constructions, the basic functions, and then register each state of the layers and the sublayers inside the state of the React.js. And then the next step would be do the rendering, do the typically HTML, CSS, as well as the event binding and trigger that will be happened, that will be given in the next video. So yeah, I will make the second part in coming few days. If you like it, just give me a thumbs, that will be really, really appreciated. I mean, making the videos sometimes need such encouragements, you know. And thank you very much for your watching, and looking forward to see you again in the next part. Bye.